Yo, what up, Buttercups? Hey, man, what's up? What's good? YouTube, the World Wide Web. It's your boy, your host with the most, Paul Cantu, back at you guys with a brand new customization video. Now, you guys saw in my last trip to the thrift, I picked up some New Balances right here. The very iconic white dad shoe. Now, these are only $13 at Goodwill. If you guys don't remember me purchasing these, then here's a nice little refresher course to re-eternalize it in your memory spectrum.
I found some New Balance dad shoes, so I'm gonna try them on. Custom coming soon, potentially?
But basically, why I'm wearing this jacket in pretty much 100 degree temperatures is because I figured, why not go ahead and actually customize these guys to be some Nautica Challenge New Balances. So they already got the N integrated. They're navy blue. I got this jacket that's navy blue. It has a hit of yellow, and then on the sleeve, it has this nice little like hit of red with the dark gray. See, it already has the dark gray integrated. So I was like, dude, why not just add some red, some more gray, and some yellow to make a perfect shoe to go with this dope ass Nautica jacket. Also, man, 90s colorway is pretty much red, forest green, navy, and yellow. So I figured these custom New Balances can go with a lot of things. Someone left a comment, they got a decent amount of likes on that video, like, hey, why don't you do some Hawaiian New Balances, bruh? I'm gonna keep it a buck. I honestly just do not feel like making these covered in like floral Hawaiian print when I would probably in all actuality never wear a shoe covered in floral Hawaiian print. But I do appreciate that idea. But without further ado, let's hop, skip, and jump into this quick Nautica New Balance customization. Let's go. All right, boys and girls, it is at that time, jumping into the tutorial. The first thing we got to do is just evaluate the kicks. Now, they are dad-esque. They're a little bit dirty, especially on the booty region, so it's time to just clean them up first and foremost. So I'll start out with just some fresh fogger to kill all the bacteria that is residing in the dad shoes. These were pretty new, so it wasn't too bad. Then I just went ahead and ripped out all of the laces just to strip it down and give a nice base to work with. Now, I did slide in these Angelus Direct shoe trees, and you guys can find those linked in the description down below, as will be all the products I use in this video. So I just slide it down, have the shoe looking right and tight, a nice form to work with. So then I start the cleaning procedure. So I just use Dawn dish soap and a little brush. I just pour the Dawn into some water. This is a quick, easy, and cheap cleaning solution. I stir it up like some witch's brew, and then I just start scrubbing the whole shoe down vigorously. Now, I was blessed that this thrifted shoe was actually pretty clean to start off with, so I didn't have to do all that much in regards to cleaning the shoe initially. I really focused on the midsole and the back just because that's the only thing that showed a little bit of wear and tear. Then I just wiped down all the soap and water concoction that was resting and residing on the kick, and then I had to prepare the shoe to paint. Now, on the back, you see that big old scuff. So that scuffing is literally nothing with this time-tested and true cleaning solution your boy has. So on the toe cap and on the back of the shoe, I just whipped out the acetone little nail polish remover. This is very cheap, affordable, with the cotton round combo, and just wiping down the shoe and rubbing it vigorously on the dirty region. You can remove pretty much any scuffs from a shoe. So if you just got some white Air Force ones that are scuffed up, this is definitely a way to quickly, sexually, and easily restorize them. And yeah, man, right here, I'm just going ahead and addressing the rest of the regions I am going to cover with paint, such as these two little curve lines. And since they're more detailed and I don't want to remove the clear coat of protective painting on the other portions of the shoe, I just pour a little bit into the cap. I get this nice little Q-tip with these detailed tips, and then I just rub down the acetone little nail polish remover all up in the crevices just to get rid of the clear protective coat right in the region your boy's gonna paint on. So the shoe pretty much at this point is ready to go to apply some paint, and the paint I'm using is flat black, light gray, red, chili red, yellow, orange, and of course some duller. And if you guys need any paint to customize the shoe, then it is linked down below. And if you cop some paint, it helps your boy out, so fuck with it. Now, the first color combo is gonna be red, chili red, and of course, two drops of duller. And literally, I put two drops of duller. It just makes the paint way less glossy and way more saucy. So when you're applying paint, if you guys have never done this in your life, thin, even coats is the mode, the method, and the technique. So the first coat of paint I'm adding is, of course, this red. And as you guys can tell, my brushstroke game, I am trying to be vicious and delicious in administering this nice cherry red combination of color. So the first coat is always going to be thin. It's going to look a little bit uneven if you guys have no experience with painting kicks. But as you add more coats of paint, the paint will even up and start looking very schmexy. Now, if you guys really aren't experienced, I highly recommend you tape the shoe. But, you know, I got that steady hand perk on a million. So, fuck tape. I'm going raw dog in this thing. But yeah, man, I'm just applying the paint to the back of the kick right now. And here is the first coat. As you guys can see, it is a little bit uneven. But that is why you just add more coats to even it out and make the paint job look profesh. You dig? So now I'm applying the second coat. You guys can already tell it is a world of a difference. And you guys might notice that I am leaving a little strip of white, and that's actually going to be the next region that I do hit with paint. So after about four coats, this is pretty much what all the red looked like when it was done. It was very even and very sexy all the way around. And now it's time to apply the second color. So the next color is going to be a combo of light gray and flat black. So the flat black actually does cut out some of the glossiness that is in the light gray, so I did not add any duller to this color. Now, a benefit of having a dark pigmented paint such as black mixed in and integrated with the paint is that you really don't need to apply that many coats. So just with this thin little brush, I'm going in there and actually adding this nice little line just to make the shoe look as professional as possible. And I only needed to add about two coats of this dark gray, so that definitely was clutch. Now, the reason I use this dark gray is because it is outlining the N for the New Balance slash Nautica logoing. And also, it just really ties the shoe together, and I feel like we'll make the whole thing look professional overall. So here is the light gray, a finish being applied in the back heel tab region, and I definitely did like it. So next color is going to be this little dark yellow. So I'm just using yellow, orange, and of course, two drops of that duller. And I'm just filling in the back heel tab around this USA embroidery. Yes, this kick was made in the United States, which definitely is a sick aspect that New Balance does do. So I definitely fuck with you, New Balance. And I also fuck with this tiny ass brush that I got at angelusdirect.com because it really helps me get in between the cracks and crevices and just make this yellow overall look nice. I had to apply about four coats of the yellow to have the paint look even and sexy. And I also did apply the yellow on the top of the tongue. Now, my whole goal with this customization was to make a custom shoe that didn't look super like customized, you know what I mean? I want it to look like it was straight from the factory. So along these curves, I am again adding that red and that yellow killer color combo just to again make the kick look as legit as possible. It's like basically creating this New Balance custom ID, except I'm IDing this shit with some Angelus paint. So I'm just adding two little thin stripes of the yellow as well, just to tie all the colors together and give the shoe a nice balance. So here are the two little curve regions painted. Again, it took some time, some steady hand perk, but just tipping it on its side, I had to finish and complete the task by just adding some nice dark gray around this little like caution New Balance stop sign, or I guess road sign looking emblem. So then I just pressed down this little tongue because it was looking sprung, and I was pretty much done at this point. I threw in some laces, and here is what the shoe looked like originally, just to remind you guys. And I definitely feel like the kicks have came a long way from the beginning. They look subtle and sexy. Without further ado, here they are on feet in these streets. Let's go. Nautica, Nautica, I got so many haters, I'm feeling yachty. Gripping a shot, shaking them haters all off of my body. Nautica, 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 rumping a jersey where niggas is purging. I'm putting that work with a mask like a surgeon. Food to Dubai and I'm fucking a Persian. A, got a Bentley Beamer and a camel. Shit, I'm balling like Julius Irving. Bitch, I'm a very important person. You already know what I'm serving. Yeah. Nautica, Nautica, Tommy Hilfiger, my fashion be splashing. You think I slip it? Cannonball in the pool, splish, splash, bitch, ooh. Pull up in something prolific. Hop out of something terrific. Nigga, my jewelry retarded. Drooling and dripping, I'm feeling autistic. Counting up digits for moving the midgets. My Audi so fast, if you blink, then you missed it. Ain't no competition, I shoot with precision. We crashing the party like head on collisions. Ay, only got cash in my visions. Free all my niggas in prison. Ay, OG round here, you can't shoot at me without asking permission. Ay. Nautica, 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 fuck with the fever. My niggas are slaughtering, yeah. Jay from Alaska, girls from Antarctica, yeah. Nautica, Nautica,
I got so many haters, I'm feeling like Yachty. Gripping a shot, shaking them haters all off of my body. Nautica, 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 fuck with the fever. My niggas are slaughter, yeah. Chief from Alaska, verse from Antarctica, yeah. Nautica, Nautica, I got so many haters, I'm feeling like Yachty. Gripping a shot, shaking them haters all off of my body.